And when we, as the men of God, can stand in our homes with our wife and our children, they're with us, and we can go, Father, I love you. I worship you. And I give you myself today. And I offer my children and my family to you. When we can do that, things are going to happen in our homes. And then when we can stand in our churches and our wives and the people around us that we've invited from work and everything else, and they look and they go, man, Brother Bucky's got his hands in the air. What's up with that? Something's happening though, you know? But they'll be able to see. And he's not ashamed. Oh, you know, we use those excuses. Well, we didn't want to offend them. They're new people. And we kind of just don't want to, you know. Well, folks, the gospel is an offense to those that are lost. Okay? We can't sit around and say, God, we just don't want to offend, so we can't do these things. Who am I supposed to stop? What time? But that's the key when we're able to do that. But first, you got to be able to do it within yourself. Because when we really start to worship, and the presence begins to inhabit and begins to fellowship with us, and we're fellowshipping with the Lord during that worship, then God's going, hey, Johnny, wait a minute. See this? Don't we need to take care of this? Right here. Yeah, Lord, let's take care of that. Right now. Let's take care of it. Let's deal with it. Okay. I've dealt with it. Now church number one is where it's supposed to be. And then we go on and on. And we affect the destiny of ourselves, our families, our churches in the world. But right now, what I want us to do for the next 5 minutes is I want us to stand and I want us to worship. No guitars, no song unless you just want to sing one. And if you all sing different songs, that's okay. Just worship.